waste no time, I'm really timeless. I cannot leave my houses without diamonds. All the pieces on my watches, jump out it. Chains, faces on the watches.
All right, so welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You see here we've got a presentation for the seniors for the Delaware State University men and women. Aaliyah Davis was honored just a little bit ago. And now they honored Mirjan Gasevich and DeAndre Haywood. Two very good players for the Hornets. DeAndre, of course, a preseason second team selection in the MEAC, scored his 1,000th point of his career last month. DeAndre, certainly one of the best players in the program's history. Gasevich, from Serbia, comes overseas. You know, this obviously difficult transition, learning a new language, things like that. And, you know, having an integral role. He's a really good back-to-the-basket player. So both of these guys putting their stamp on the program in their own way. And now they're going to get an opportunity tonight to maybe get a win for the for their final time in front of the MEAC fan, or in front of the Memorial Hall fans, Tyson.
Yeah, that'll be a great experience for the two seniors going out on their last home game to get a win.
It's so hard to say goodbye to all my senior Greeks. Y'all graduating this year. Special shout out to the class of 2017. Make some noise. If you're graduating this year in May, if you're graduating in the winter, still make some noise. Class of 2020, where you at? Don't forget. Listen. We need to all your Greeks to go on and on and support this last home game. What's my favorite word? Miss DSU, I need you to get wild, crazy in a good way. I need all y'all. Have a lot of fun. Let's get it in. What we got?
Can't understand how I last so long. Must had a super
go to
last 223,000 hours and it's cause I'm off of CC.
You're the strongest, skinniest guy I know. And like your you dogs don't know how to act. You know we got celebrity in the house.
I got girls that I should have made pay for it.
HGB.
Got girls that I should have made way for it.
Y'all need a healing. This is the man.
Right back home. Stay another day for it. You got attitude on nana. No agua.
You're supposed to clap right there.
Is it just me? Is it just me? Is this so, so good? I shouldn't have to. Is it just me? Yeah. Is it just me? Is this so, so good? I shouldn't have to. For free. I know you work today, ready to get a college degree. Ain't nobody that you know and even know you're free. Right? You know you only do that with me. Right?
Shout out to the Greeks.
Look at more.
Now this is what's gonna happen, right? Right before the tip, we're gonna get everybody on their feet, including all my Greeks. And you're gonna get that. Get up, Dale State. Dale State, get up. It's the last game. I need y'all to get hyped. I need y'all to get on your feet and show the boys how we do. Show these Bison how I go down. At DSU, shout out to the Bison. This is a Bison by himself. By himself, girl.
This is my town. Take the block, make it hot now.
You know, Bison is like a buffalo.
Drop down. Icy chain with the watch now. Both piece full of rocks now. Squint when they watch now. Leveling up to the top now.
Razor man, Razor, Ramon man. All right, everybody on your feet. You know what time it is.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, for the final time this season. We get ready for MEAC men's basketball as the Delaware State University Hornets taking on the Bison from Howard University. As the two teams get ready to introduce their starters, Tavon, we will start with keys to the game. Hornets on a three-game losing streak. They're 1-6 this season at home. Keys to the game, get off the schneid and head into the MEAC tournament with some momentum.
All right, our Hornets' keys to the game are three-point shooting. Our Hornets are currently shooting 36% from the three-point field, from the 3-point field. So if they can get some 3-point shots going tonight, rebounding, their margin is 6.6 points rebounds per game. So they need to stay on top of the rebound margin and not let Howard get too many rebounds, too many offensive rebounds. And senior night, we have two seniors tonight on our Delaware State team. So our momentum, our confidence should be up for our senior. They should want to go out with the bang tonight. So I'm looking to see our two seniors perform well tonight and get a W for our Hornets.
All right, so there are your keys to the game. Now with the two teams, with the starting lineups being announced, we'll get you those. Starting for Howard, going to be Kofu, Ondo, Marcel Boyd, Solomon Mangham, Charles Williams, and Damon Collins, the starters for Howard University. As for Delaware State, it will be Kevon Waller, Devon Mallory, Devin Morgan, and the two seniors getting an opportunity to start. DeAndre Haywood, one we typically see start, but Merjon Gasevich going to get the start in his final home game as a Hornet. Tay, there's the starting lineups. Who are your keys to the, or who are your impact players on those two teams?
Our impact player for Dell State tonight is DeAndre Haywood. DeAndre currently averages 11.1 points per game. Tonight is his last DSU home game as he is a senior. So I expect him to come out hot. I expect him to come out with a lot of energy. And he is currently second in the conference in steals. Our impact player for Howard is Charles Wilson. Charles is a very efficient three-point shooter. He averages 16.1 points per game. So if he gets going and Dell State allows him to get that stroke going, it's going to be a long night for him. So hopefully he doesn't, our Dell State defense doesn't want him to get going.
So there are your impact players. We get ready for action. The lights still out here, but we're getting ready to go to work. Two teams near the bottom of the conference. Hornets ninth in the conference at 6-9. Howard one game behind them. They're 5-10. Everybody ahead of North Carolina A&T, NC A&T, 0-16 on the season. But Delaware State, really, there's a wide range they could go. They could end up as the 7th seed. They're one game behind Coppin State and South Carolina State, or they could end up as the 12th seed. They're only one game ahead of Florida A&M, Bethune-Cookman, and Howard. With the way tiebreakers and things work out, there's a wide range of where this team could be. Obviously, though, tonight's important. They're 1-6 at home this season in MEAC play. They've lost 3 in a row, the last 2 at home, and now you've got a team that has been a little bit better than this season. I think this is one Coach Walker expects to win. Tay, first 4 minutes, first media timeout. What are you looking for? What do the Hornets need to do?
I'm definitely looking to see the Hornets get out to a nice start. Like you said, this is a very important game for them, especially since it's a MEAC game, the last home game, last game before the tournament. They need to get this win so they can move up within the standings. They're in the middle of the pack right now, so this game is a big game when it comes to their momentum and their confidence. So I just look to see them come out and play their game and win this game against Howard.
And Howard won the only meeting between these two teams last year, and this the only meeting between the two teams this year. And we get ready for the tip. Marcel Boyd and Merjon Gasevich go at it, and Gasevich wins the tip. Devin Morgan brings it up, and the chant of get up, Dell State, get up, working through the crowd, cheering on their team till that first field goal is made.
That's a nice way to finish, to start his last senior game, his last home game, winning the tip. His last one of his college career.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. Haywood's got it, looking to go to work. He'll drive to that left, fade away, and no good. Gasevich going after the rebound, but Marcel Boyd comes up with it.
Howard has a lot of size now.
The other way.
I'm looking at the center and the point, power forward for Howard. They're a pretty big guy, so I'm wondering how the power forward in the center for Dell State is going to handle against him tonight, especially being rebounding one of the keys to success for Dell State tonight.
Hornets in that 2-3 zone. That's Ondo trying to beat it from the free throw line, but it's no good, and it's out of bounds off of Howard. So the Hornets will go back to work on offense. Hornets in that 2-3 zone defensively. Waller, Gasevich, and Mallory working that back line. And you hear this crowd, they're into it on senior night, trying to cheer on the boys and get that second MEAC win here at Memorial Hall. from three. Kevon Waller knocks it down, and there's a good way to get the scoring going. Waller, one of the best three-point shooters in the MEAC, opens it up for the Hornets.
And there's that. Oh, there's a steal by DeAndre Haywood and a layup.
That's why he's second in the conference in steals. Haywood aggressive, jumps the pass, and a quick 5-0 lead for the Hornets.
And just like I had mentioned before the game, three-point shooting is going to be a big key tonight. And Dell State's already 1-for-1, knocking down one in the corner.
And we saw this against UMES. The Hornets got out to a big lead. They were up 16-2 and 19-4. They were up 16 points midway through the first half and ultimately ended up losing the game by 1 point. So good start to the game, but you know, we just saw it with this Hornet team on Saturday. They've got to play the full 40 minutes. They're not good enough to, you know, take breaks and have mental lapses. They've got to play the full 40 minutes at maximum effort.
Definitely, Chris, definitely.
So Kevon Waller commits the foul.
Quick foul there, we're only 2 minutes in. Dell State dropping back into this 2-3 zone. Let's see what Howard does to combat that.
And Howard in a bit of a feeling out process early on in their half court. And here a three ball pulled up, no good, but the long rebound by Boyd.
And there's an offensive rebound for Howard there. That's something that Dell State does not want to get in the habit of, letting Howard get offensive rebounds and letting him get extra possessions.
And there, a three ball pulled up and good by number 12, Solomon Mangham.
And that's what happens when you let teams get extra possessions, things like that happen.
And he dumped inside to Gasevich. Gasevich goes to work with that little scoop shot. He gets it to go.
He's a very, very, very good back to the basket player. Very efficient in the low block. He loves that sky hook, that fake pivot. And turning back over that right, left shoulder and throwing up that right hook.
And you see that, you can tell he's from overseas. He fits the mold, and there's Haywood creating more havoc on the defensive end. But Gasevich, he fits the bill of an overseas player, very skilled offensive big man. And Gasevich showing. He hasn't gotten as many minutes probably as he would like. Demola Onafade has been inserted into the starting lineup. Onafade, a big defensive guy, and brings the rebounding as well. But Gasevich, a good offensive player, and showing he can be important to this team. Here's Devon Mallory, the local kid, comes up short, and Mangham gets the rebound.
Just a little background on Devon Mallory. He was 2015 Delaware State Gatorade Player of the Year in high school. Very good high school player. Interested to see what he can do tonight here in this game.
And Solomon Mangham knocks down another one from the outside. Here's Gasevich inside again. Probably wanted a foul call, but he won't get it.
Probably should have got one there, Chris. They mauled him.
The Hornets will reset. Kevon dumps it into Gasevich. Gasevich drives with the left hand. No good. Mallory, the tip back won't go. And Gasevich knows he couldn't pick it up because he was out of bounds. But it's off of Howard, so the Hornets we'll get possession again when we come back. First media timeout, 7-6 Tay. Early impressions.
Delaware State is playing well. They're allowing too many offensive rebounds to Howard, which explains why Howard's still in this game right now. And they're looking pretty stagnant on offense. I want to see them move the ball around some more. I like the way that they're attacking the basket. I want them to continue to do that and not settle for that many jump shots, because
see some highlights from that first 4 minutes. And senior night, Greek night, fan appreciation day, a lot going on here at Memorial Hall. And you can hear it in the background, the fans, this stadium loud, supporting their basketball team again in the final home game of their MEAC regular season.
Yeah, like I was saying, Chris Howard's very well, very good rebounding team, so you don't want to shoot too many long jumpers and have too many long rebounds with them, because that's how they get out in transition. That's not what you want.
Hey, hey. Alpha Fraternity Incorporated.
Hold on, they can't hear y'all. Do it into the mic.
Who you with? Who you with? God damn it, I
said. He said, who you with?
So we get ready to go back to it. Just over 4 minutes into the game, 15:56 to go, and a one-point lead for the Hornets. Solomon Mangham, the 2 3-pointers for Howard that's kept them in this game. And here, poor job inbounding from the Hornets. Morgan got to go all the way back under his own basket to get it. But they have it, and they'll go to work on offense.
One thing I am noticing about Howard, they're in this zone defense and they have some big guys and they're long too. They have some long wingspan and it's looking very difficult for Del State to move the ball through that zone due to the long arm span of Howard. So we'll see how DSU combats that throughout this game.
And so you saw Devin Morgan pull up the deep three there, no good. And Ondo saved it. And Howard will go back to work on offense. Here's Williams from downtown, no good. He's 0 for 2 early on. Charles Williams, you talk about normally an efficient three-point shooter, but 0 for 2 early on, and now DeAndre Haywood falls for travel.
Yeah, that's a good sign to see. One of their best scorer and one of their better three-point shooters, 0 for 2 so far. So let's see what he can do to get going here in this game, Chris.
Solomon Mangham, no slouch of his own. He's second on the team in three-point field goals made, and he also leads the team in rebounds. So Mangham making his presence felt early on for the Bison. And here he is, two-man game inside-outside, and Mangham left alone. He's 3 for 3 from downtown.
That's 9 quick points around Chris.
So now Howard takes their first lead of the game, up 9-7. Morgan, some crafty moves, goes to the left hand and a lay-in.
Beautiful finish, left-hand finish from Morgan there. He's not the biggest guy, but he figures out how to get it up over the defense and almost another steal by Haywood there.
Yeah, and on senior night, Haywood, the lefty there, nice little tribute from Devin Morgan to finish with the left hand up and under and tie this game up. Here's Williams, another three, no good. So. A slow start for Charles Williams. Mangham, though, picking up the slack for him.
I think I jinxed him in pregame, Chris.
Haywood met by Williams out at the top of the key. Now Waller's got Williams on him. Now Morgan's got it. He kicks it over to Haywood from downtown. No good.
Long rebound. Howard picks it up.
So back the other way, we've got a carry called.
That's a good call.
On Damon Collins. So 9-9 here early on, and one player doing all the scoring for Howard, Solomon Mangham, 3 for 3 from downtown.
Del State's offense looking real stagnant still here. They're struggling to move that ball against this tenacious zone defense of Howard. Kind of reminds you of Syracuse's 2-3, where they have those long players, long arms. It's very hard to move the ball around and get inside of the 2-3, which is what you need to do to beat it.
Gasovich tries to dump inside to Mallory, but it gets tipped away. And Mallory fakes a couple of defenders out, puts up a floater at the rim, no good, gets his own rebound and puts it back. And Mallory, the easy lay-in to put the Hornets back in front.
Great hustle by Mallory there. He's a special player. He can do a little bit of it all. He can shoot. He can dribble. And he's pretty tall, so he rebounds, plays defense very well.
Here's another three from Mangham. Finally misses. Mallory gets the rebound. And the Hornets come back the other way looking to extend the lead. You can see, though, Howard really respects this three-point shooting ability from Delaware State. They've really stretched out their zone. Mallory tries to go inside with the pass, and it's swatted away by Tyler Stone.
There's another example of Howard's long long reach there in the zone. Mallory tried to get that pass through that zone, and they just weren't having it. They swatted it away. There was only another turnover for Del State.
And now a foul called on Mallory.
Somebody.
11-9 the score here early on, 12:44 remaining in the first half. Collins to inbounds looking for Williams. Williams goes back to Collins. Wanted some good defense here on the inbounds. And now the long rebound, Morgan in transition. A good decision there, though, didn't have the numbers. Haywood shot blocked by Stone. Haywood gets it back, though. Another steal for DeAndre Haywood.
Great hustle by Haywood there.
Morgan was open for three, couldn't get it to go. And he's 0 for 2 to start. Both teams have had a couple of open jumpers here. Solomon Mangham seems to be the only one that can knock them down consistently.
Yeah, I was just about to mention that despite the zone from Howard, Del State has had some good looks. They just haven't been able to knock most of them down.
And boy, that down low, no good.
Great defense by Devon Mallory there.
Excuse me, that was Tyler Stone down low for the layup. But good defense nonetheless from the Hornets. And now we'll see what they do on the offensive end. This possession, Dana Razor at the scorer's table, so he gets ready to check in.
Let's see what kind of sets Delaware State runs here to get that ball down inside in that zone.
Good pass inside by Haywood, but Gasevich wasn't ready for it and drops it. And some low passes here on this possession from Howard, but ultimately another missed three from Charles Williams, 0 for 4. Not a good start, and we talked about it. He's one of the more efficient three-point shooters in the conference, but early on here, he's struggling.
Yeah, shots just not falling, which is a good thing for Del State. That's why they hold this 11 to 9 lead. So let's see if they can get some points up on the board and stretch this lead while Howard's best player is not scoring as his usual rate.
And we've got a foul called, another one on Devon Mallory. So Mallory's going to pick up his second foul. And so that will take us to the second media timeout. Mallory's got two fouls. He spent some time injured this season, but when he's been on the floor, the Hornets have been much better. Now with two fouls, we'll see what the Hornets do without him. Up 11-9, 10:52 to go in this first half. As you see some highlights, and both teams struggled on offense. Neither have been really efficient from anywhere on the floor. Solomon Mangham really the one man changing that. He's 3 of 4 from downtown, but had some open looks, but nobody really able to get going offensively. We'll see if anybody can when we get back. Timeout. Hornets up 11-9. And here Damon Collins fakes the three, drives, and gets a mid-range jumper to go to tie this game back up at 11.
Yeah, we got some poor shooting from both teams here. Howard currently shooting 4 for 12. Delaware State shooting 5 for 16. Let's see if one of these teams, if not both, can pick it up and get hot from the field here.
So DeAndre Haywood back at the top. Kevon Waller from way downtown. He gets it to go. Waller Waller started out the season as one of the best three-point shooters in the country. He's tapered off a little bit, falling to fourth in the MAAC in three-point shooting percentage, but that's still a threat. He's still dangerous up near the top of the conference, and now 2-for-2 to open up.
A couple months ago in December, he tied the DSU record for most three-pointers in a game. He went 8-for-9. He was just filling it.
And now an answer, this one from James J.T. Miller. He knocks it down from downtown, and Howard hanging right with the Hornets, 14-14.
A lot of threes being shot here. Of course, you got 13 threes combined between the two teams shot in the first 10 minutes.
So all of the starting lineup except for Devon Mallory on the floor for the Hornets. Dana Razor has checked in. He thought about pulling up the three, but thought better of it. And now Morgan swings it over to Haywood. Haywood's going to drive with just two on the shot clock and draw a foul. And I believe that one's going to be on Marcel Boyd. It is, and that's DeAndre Haywood's game. He's got a solid mid-range game, but he loves to put the ball on the floor and attack the rim.
That's what Delaware State needs to break down this zone here. They need to pass the ball around, get defenders moving, and break it down and get down into that zone.
And the thing you love about DeAndre, on senior night, we've seen him be aggressive, but his aggression's been on the defensive end. He's been going after steals. He's been getting after the basketball on the defensive end. Offensively, he hasn't forced anything. He hasn't tried to do too much, despite it being senior night.
All right, Chris, and that's what you'd like to see. You like to see your players two-way oriented, showing energy on both sides of the ball.
And now you see Dana Razor up at the top of that zone. Young man, 6'5", 200 pounds, but a lot of length on him. And he can bother some teams with that 3-2 zone, put him up top. And Coach Walker trying to take advantage of that here. Good dump inside to Boyd, but it's no good.
Great defense there by the Hornets.
Waller, you said a great defense, Waller. Good job to go straight up, not get the foul called on him, and Boyd gets a impeded look at the basket and can't finish. And Haywood goes back inside to Gasevich. He kicks it out to Waller. Another three is good.
Great inside-out game there by the Hornets. Great inside-out game.
And you see Howard, they know about Gasevich's inside game. Every time he gets the basketball down low, he's got two or three guys standing around him. And Gasevich there does a good job to pass out of it and find the open Kevon Waller.
And it seems like the coaching knows that, and they keep going back to it so they can exploit it. Because every time he gets the ball down to that post, they collapse on him. He kicks it back out, and there's an open three.
Miller from way downtown gets it to go.
That was almost from the blue line, Chris. Wow.
If you're Coach Walker, you live with that. You can't stretch the zone out that far.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do about that one. That's just a great shot.
Haywood's got some separation, thought about pulling up. Razor from way downtown trying to answer, no good. But Gasevich showing he's not just on the floor for senior night. He's playing some very effective minutes here early on in the basketball game.
He's playing great basketball. Another offensive rebound for Gasevich.
So Gasevich put up a good effort there on that possession. Grabbed two offensive rebounds, but the Hornets not able to convert. Another immediate timeout. Kobe Gantz will check back in when we get back after the under eight timeout.
The Smooth Brothers. I told you I seen Kappa shimmying in her funeral. I said, oh my gosh. By the time they go, time I'm gonna be over. I see you, Kappa Alpha Psi, Smooth Brothers. Shout out to all my ladies that love Kappas. If you love a Kappa, make some noise. Look, look at them, ladies. They looking at y'all. Look at them, ladies. All right, off the court, fellas. All right. Show some love for the Kappa Alpha Psi. We got to go. We got to go. Grab your canes and get off. Grab your canes. Grab your canes. Look at this. Y'all got to run, brothers. They too cool. Look at these two cool guys.
You know, son, I swear to God, I got the Apple iTunes in my ear. I can't hear them.
So after the under eight media timeout, we're back to work. Close game, two teams going back and forth. Delaware State, the 19-17 edge.
Despite Delaware State's two-point lead, they're killing Howard on the boards right now, 15-8 currently. So that's one of my keys to success for Delaware State, and they're currently controlling the board, which is nice to see. There's another rebound for Delaware State. Now they're pushing the ball down.
And I believe that was Williams with another miss. Waller thought about the three, instead dishes over to Razor. Razor finds the cutting DeAndre Haywood, and he will draw a foul. So Haywood going to go back to the line, and there you see more of it. Haywood wants to get to the basket, and he's going to go to the free throw line for the second time tonight.
Damon Collins, his first, team second. Shooting two.
And Haywood, no good there, but nonetheless, he's going to go down as one of the best players in Hornet history, over 1,000 points, been a part of a lot of successful teams, and I think this team's got the potential to make some noise in the MEAC tournament. Only two teams have beaten North Carolina Central this year in MEAC play. One of them was Delaware State at NC Central.
Yeah, DSU's always had some great success against NCCU, and I believe this year this team is poised to make a good run in the MEAC, so we'll see how they'll play. They're looking good tonight. They just need to get some good offensive sets going and knock down some shots. And they're playing great defense and they're rebounding really well.
And we've got an off the ball whistle. It's going to go against Howard, so it will be Hornet basketball.
Let's see if Hornets can stretch this lead past three here.
I think the call was against Marcel Boyd, in which case it would be his second. And now Morgan tries to get to the basket, and Charles Williams is called for the foul.
As you can see here, Dell State basketball is definitely emphasizing getting into the lane and not settling for threes. As you can see, two straight possessions resulting in two straight fouls as they've tried to penetrate the lane.
So Charles Williams off to a slow start for Howard. And I think if you're Howard, only being down three with Charles Williams struggling like he is, probably not a bad sign.
Well, it's funny you say that, Chris. Delaware State's not shooting as well as they should be either, which would explain why they're only up 3 points. Big shot there.
Haywood finishing through the contact. Little stuck in the air, floating jump shot, and Haywood gets it to go.
You can definitely tell he's pumped for his senior night. He's in the zone right now. He's doing everything. He's passing, he's playing defense, he's driving, he's finishing the shots.
And we've got a whistle. Kavon Waller is hurt. Hanging on to what looks like his right elbow, right wrist, something like that. Kavon Waller, very important player for the Hornets. He's knocked down a couple of threes here early on. Three three-pointers.
Currently three for four from the three-point field.
So, but we'll get our first look now at the Mola Onafade. And now Williams again falling away short on this one. And there's Onafade skying up for the rebound.
He's key to their rebounding success. Onafade is a very physical player, very tall, long, lengthy player. Very good rebounder.
Under 10 to go on the shot clock. Morgan drives, goes to Onafade, and Onafade can't handle the pass. But a great dish there from Devin Morgan. Onafade, that's one of the things we've seen him struggle with on offense. You know, he hasn't always had the opportunity to see the foul called here. Williams gets to the basket. But Onafade sometimes just struggles to catch the basketball. I think he's in a hurry sometimes to get to the basket. And there you see a result of it.
And you see that a lot with players that are very strong on defense. Their offense is not as polished as their defensive game, and they don't do well with catching the ball down low, especially with those guards. Those passes come in hot. So maybe let's see if there's something he can work on.
Williams gets the first to go. Onafade, the 6'9 sophomore out of Nigeria. So he's still got some refining to do to his games. I think he's really come into his own on the defensive side, rebounding the basketball. I think this offseason, Coach Walker's progress or project for him is going to be working on his offensive game.
Yeah, I was going to mention that Onafade is only a sophomore. So when you have a player and you're trying to develop him being good on defense already is a great start. So all you got to do is work on offense. You can teach offense. Defense is something that you either have or you don't. You can teach effort, but defense is something that you can't really teach.
And so Coach Walker with Onafade on the floor, he's going to get Artem in. Kind of clogged the lane a little bit less, takes Gasevich out. And now here's DeAndre Haywood driving to the basket, blocked by Charles Williams. And now a foul, a block on Miller. And the fans unhappy. They wanted a foul down here on this end on DeAndre Haywood's lay-in attempt. I think you can make the argument that there was a foul on the contact. I think Williams got the block clean.
Yeah, I believe the refs were paying more attention to the block than the contact before the block, because there was definitely some contact there that should have warranted a foul call.
So a three-point game, 22-19. And Miller thought about the three. Charles Williams gets open from downtown, but another miss.
And he continues to struggle here, Chris.
And Marcel Boyd gets the offensive rebound. And using that big body of his to create some space and get the lay-in.
Yeah, Marcel Boyd, 6'11", 225. That's a big guy down there. Let's see if Onafade can get some position on him and box him out so he's not grabbing too many offensive rebounds, resulting in extra chances and more points as he just did there.
22-21. Haywood wants his guys to move without the basketball. And the pass deflected away. Artem's got to go quick.
Great call there by the ref. I believe the Howard player's feet were just barely in the restricted area, resulting in a blocking foul. Great call there.
We're going to get another look at it. Coach not happy with it. Marcel Boyd not happy with the call as well. You see here Williams gets the shot. And I believe this is Kevon Waller's open three. So I lied to you. We don't have the look for you. But, Tay, you thought it was a good call.
It was a great call, yeah. Your feet can be restricted in the restricted area. The defender was there. The defender was set. But if your feet are in the restricted area, it should be a blocking call every time.
And a good job by Artem realizing he had time to attack the basket and get there. But Artem, the frustrations at the free throw line continue. We go back to the Hampton game, and we brought it up just about every game this season. But this team was 2-0 in the MEAC, and in their first home game, Artem was at the line in a tie game with 2 seconds left and missed both free throws, and they end up losing the game in overtime. And I'm not sure it's something Artem's really gotten over yet.
Yeah, Delaware State currently shoots 65% from the free throw line, which is pretty below average. If you ask me, that should be up around mid-70%.
And there's Mangham again. And that will put Howard in front for the first time today, 24-23.
And Mangham is feeling it from three-point tonight, Chris. Every shot that he's taken tonight has been a three-pointer. He's currently 4-for-5.
Mangham, half of the Howard points, and a dangerous pass from Razor. Morgan spots up from downtown. He responds. Devin Morgan puts the Hornets back out in front.
This looks like the all-star three-point shootout tonight, Chris. They're just letting it fly.
And so the two teams settling in on the offensive side of the floor. And here's Collins driving in the basket up and over Damola Onafade with the lay-in.
That's a great left-hand finish. Onafade was right there to contest that basket. But Collins just went over the top and finished with the left hand.
So 26 all, the two teams going back and forth. Largest lead of the game was 5-4 Delaware State, and that was with the score 5-0. Our Tim, crafty movement and a good dish to Dana Razor, but he can't finish. Gets his own rebound and misses another layup.
Great hustle there by Dana Razor. He just didn't finish the shot, which is, it happens. But that's a layup that he has to make. Hopefully he's not hurt here on the fall down to the floor, hustling for that rebound.
Yeah, I think he might have got the back of his head coming down for the rebound, but he's up and walking. You see Artem, great movement. And Razor just couldn't finish either time. And here, looked like the neck snapping back was what got him, but he's up and able to get back to the bench on his own. So 2.5 minutes to go, 26 all, two teams going back and forth. Tay, what have you seen so far?
I see Delaware State has still shot the ball great from three, but they've let some offensive rebounds get some defensive rebounds get away from them on the defensive side, resulting in some extra possessions for Howard. So they need to cut down on those, and they should be in the lead of this game, but it's currently tied.
I see you try. Look at this guy. This guy graduated with me. He's a teacher now. This guy's a teacher now. I see you try. Oh, me at football player right there. Oh, Omega Chi Phi. Oh, all right, show some love for Omega Chi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Like, I gotta get off the court. You got it. All right, you gotta go. All right, I know. Look, he don't wanna get off. Shout out to my man with the 50 cent. He got the 50 cent vest on. Omega Sci-Fi. I'm looking for somebody with those gold boots.
So 2.5 minutes to go here in the first half of action, 26 all. And Howard with the basketball.
Looking to see Howard shooting 6 for 11 from the three-point line, which has kept them in this game. They're shooting 42% from the field. On Dell State, they're shooting 34% from the field, but shooting 44% from the three. So let's see if they can heat up from anywhere besides the three-point line.
And so Ondo able to knock down the long two to put Howard out in front. And now the Hornets try and respond. Razor from the middle of that zone goes over to Onafade. And he gets his shot blocked. Artem comes up with the loose ball. And it's going to be out of bounds. And it will be Howard basketball.
A very awkward offensive move by Onafonde there. It kind of looked like he didn't know what to do with it when he got it. And like you mentioned before, that's a project that Coach Williams would work on this summer.
So 28-26, Howard out in the front. Their largest lead has been two, and now we get a travel called against Tyler Stone. Stone, not exactly a ball handler, and showed it there with the traveling violation. Hornets back the other way.
See if they can successfully break down this Howard zone.
And we're going to get an over the back call against Demola Onafade.
DSU still currently leading the rebound battle here, despite being down two.
Langham was open, got it to Tyler Stone, and this one blocked by Damone Onafade, and they get a call. Who's the foul going to be on?
Great question. It's, there was a couple of Hornets around the ball there.
Foul was on Razor, so Onafade had a clean block. But we'll see here. Razor was.
He caught a piece of the arm on the way back. Yep.
Yeah, Razor was too low. Onafide had it clean. And Stone misses the first at the line.
Great foul there. See if he can make the second one here.
Howard up two. Stone trying to extend it to three, and he goes 0 for 2 at the line. So an empty possession there for Howard.
Currently look at Delaware State's lineup. They don't have really any inside players on the court. Just a 4 3-point shooters and Onafide. And it shows as they're moving the ball around the perimeter, not really looking to get it inside as often as they were earlier in the game.
Well, you've seen it. Demo Onafide just doesn't look comfortable on offense with the ball in his hands. And he struggled on the offensive end, and Devin Morgan's going to get a timeout. 12 seconds on the shot clock, 14 and a half remaining in the first half of action. And it's 28 to 26. Hornets, if they hang on to it long enough, likely can hang on for the final possession. Just a slight difference between shot and game clock.
One thing about it, shout out to the Panhellenic 9, where you at, make some noise. I need them calls right now. I need all them calls. Where the cap is at? Where the cap is at? Where them alphas at?
So Mahir Johnson has checked in for Demo Onafide here for the final possession of the first half.
See if Del State can get a nice shot out. Haywood's three's up, and it's good.
DeAndre Haywood.
Half-court
so
shot.
The senior knocks down the three. Damon Collins short with the half-court buzzer beater. Table going to the half, 29 to 28. Hornets out in front, back and forth game in the first half.
Delaware State has controlled the rebounding like I figured that they would and that they needed to win. So let's see if they can go into the half, make the current adjustment to stop Howard from shooting so well from the three, and they can come out here in the second half and stretch this lead that they have.
All right, so we'll come back after this halftime break for the second half of action. The Hornets up one on Howard with DeAndre Haywood's three, 29-28 Hornets.
As they can. All right. Team OVO. Team Bundles. On your mark, get set, go. Don't forget, it's a relay. It's a relay. No, one at a time. One at a time. And then put it in there. Speed kills. You got to run fast. Oh, she runs. Look at them Uggs. Look at them Uggs. Oh, get him. Go, Bundles. Look at her hair. Look at her hair. Oh, don't fall, because I swear to gosh, you would have ended up on World Star. You better not fall. Let's go. Let's go. And the Uggs. There you go. Let's go. Get it. Get it. Get it. Get it. Let's go. Mr. Senior. With tight clothes on. What is Michael? Oh, you ain't in shape. He getting tired. He ain't in shape. He getting tired. He got his workout gear on. Let's go. With the joggers on. Grab another one. Grab two of them. Uh-oh. She might win. Slide, slide. All right. Give a round of applause for both teams. Team OVO crew. Clap it up for them one time. Thank you. Shout out to Team Bundles. And the winner is Team Bundles. Oh, I'm sorry, we had an Oscar moment. It's Team OVO crew. Yeah, you see the Oscars? All right. Now both of y'all winners, both of you guys win t-shirts. All right, next up, we got that Unity Strong. So get your cameras out, all my Greeks. Breeze, you ready? Let's go.
I don't say a word, I don't say a word. What's on my
crowd? I need all my Greeks out there, where y'all at? Y'all thought we was finished? What happened? We're getting started over. We ain't gonna let y'all come out like that. We ain't gonna let y'all come out like that. Back up, back up, back up. This was going down. We got 5 minutes or 4 minutes. Breeze, you ready? I need all of y'all to grab your place on the floor. Here we go. We got 3 minutes. Over y'all. All my Greeks, Breezy, let's go.
I don't say a word.
Hold up, y'all ain't on your feet to cry. Y'all better stand on your feet, cause somebody gonna get in your way. Let's go, Breeze, drop that.
I don't say a word. I don't say a word. What's on my crowd? I got a
hold up, wait a minute. Y'all thought this thing was finished? When we got them Greeks, yeah, y'all thought it was finished? All my Greeks strolling at the same time. That's what we do at DSU. The DSU Unity Stroll. Everybody. All my Greeks.
Street, stop it, jump it, bump it, and we gon' go fit this day of faith. Throwing the balls, I'm back, it's
integrity deep up in this party. So we just gotta stay off the court.
Thinking that far. always out and you never get old. And the champagne's always cold and the music's always good. And the pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood. And they hop they pretty act up on the hood of that pretty ass car without a wrinkle in today. Cause there's no tomorrow, just a picture perfect day that lasts a whole lifetime. And it never ends, cause all we have to do is hit rewind. So let's just stay in the moment, smoke some, drink some wine, reminisce, talk some, forever young is in your mind. Leave them off, they can't erase neither space nor time. So when the director yells cut, I'll be fine. I'm forever young.
Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever and ever.
Forever, you know I'm on my fault, and I ain't with foreclosure. I will never forfeit less than four bars. Google bring the chorus in. Did you get the picture yet? I'm painting you a portrait of young.
Forever young, I wanna be forever young, forever young. Do you really want to live forever, forever, forever young?
And so there you saw the video tribute that they played here at Memorial Hall minutes ago till the second half. DeAndre Haywood, Mirjan Gasevich, the two seniors for the Hornets. Last game at Memorial Hall. Tay, the two of them had a pretty good impact there for the Hornets in that first half.
Yes, they did. Gasevich had a bucket in the first half, along with two rebounds, and DeAndre Haywood had 10 points on 3-for-7 shooting, 3-for-4 at the free throw line, knocking down one of his two threes.
And so we saw the struggles with Onafide ahead in the first half. Devon Mallory's got two fouls. I've got to think Mirjan Gasevich is going to get back in this game because they were up when he was on the floor.
Yeah, they definitely were more efficient when he was on the floor. He's a good rebounder, good defender, and he gives them a presence inside that can score the ball.
Another key thing to look at, Kevon Waller left with about 5-6 minutes to go in that first half with what appeared to be a right elbow wrist something on the arm injury. He's 3-for-4 from downtown. Hornets are going to need him if they're going to win this basketball game. He's too good of a three-point shooter.
Definitely. That's a key impact to this game if he doesn't come back due to that elbow or wrist injury that he has. So that's definitely something to look out for in the second half.
So the clocks are down to zero and they'll reset at 20 minutes. We get ready to go to work for the second half of action. Fans filing back into their seats. It looks like Gasevich and Waller both will be out to start the second half. You saw there at halftime all the Greeks out on the floor doing a performance. We talked about tonight being Greek night. Tay, I thought that was pretty cool. It was very loud in here during
that.
Yeah,
because here at Delaware State, we're HBCU, so you got the Divine Nine. We got most of the Divine Nine here, and to see everybody together dancing, doing their strolls and their steps at the same time, just a great thing to see.
And so Kevon Waller inbounds to Devin Morgan, and we get ready to go back to work in the second half, 29-28. Hornets are on top. Two and teams fighting to stay out of that 12th seed in the MEAC. We talked about the Hornets have a chance to jump up as high as 7th heading into the MEAC tournament and could fall as far down as 12.
Just a comment, Kevon Waller is back in the game currently. So the injury must not have been that bad because he's out here in the starting five in the second half for the Hornets.
So Kofi Ando called for the foul.
Bad foul there. There's only 7 seconds left in the shot clock. I can't see any reason for him to make that foul there, but fortunate for the Hornets, they get a new 30 on the shot clock. Hopefully they can get some points out of this possession and start the half and get off to a good start in this half.
And Morgan pulls up from downtown, gets it to go. And DeAndre Haywood closed the first half with a three. Devin Morgan opens up the second half with a three of his own.
And that's his second three of the game. He's currently 2-for-5 from the three-point line.
So the Hornets open the lead up to 4. Same 5 as the starting lineup for both teams. It's Collins. And there you see Williams down low. He can't get it to go.
Hey, you can definitely see the length that Delaware State now has on the floor with Waller, Mallory, and Gasevich down low. It was hard for him, Collins, to get that shot up over the lengthy arms of the three that they have down low. I feel like this is Delaware State's best lineup that they have on the floor right now.
Gasevich from the free throw line, no good, but Mallory comes up with the offensive rebound. And you talk about the length the Hornets brought out, it's going to improve the zone, but also offensively there you see an offensive rebound. And back inside to Gasevich, goes up with the left hand, no good.
Let's see if Howard can get a nice offensive possession going here. And it's an air ball, actually, from Howard. So they continue to struggle offensively. Besides the couple of threes that they hit in the first half, they've struggled pretty greatly offensively, which is surprising because they're only losing by 4 points here. So let's see if Delaware State can get a push and make a run and increase this lead that they have over Howard.
And you see Charles Williams is going to come off. They're going to bring in JT Miller for him. Williams, this is not the usual Charles Williams that we typically see for Howard. And now a turnover, and it's going to be a walk. Miller had the steal, but got it stuck up on his shoulder and walked with it.
I think my man got too excited there. He was on the show the crowd a little something, and he got too excited and walked. So ball back to the Hornets here. Lucky break there off the turnover.
So just underway here in the second half, and Chris Moore alongside Tavon Callaway, final home game of the season for the Hornets. And there's Haywood dumping off to Gasevich, the two seniors getting
great
the
pack.
Hornets going here in the second half.
That's what they're going to need if they want to continue to score officially on the offensive end. They're going to have to break down that zone, penetrate into the middle of it, and find his big man.
And another air ball from that right wing. And now Morgan trying to push it, but he'll bring it back out and pull up the three. Gets it
he
to go
it
and
down.
The lead up to seven.
He's feeling it right
nine.
Now. He's feeling it. And a smart timeout by Howard coach Mr. Nickelberry there. Get some momentum. Delaware State's momentum is taking over currently right now. The crowd's getting into it. The shots are falling. They just have way more energy than the Howard team does. That was a great timeout by the coach.
The timeout. Hornets off to an 8-0 run to open up this second half of action, and now lead by nine.
Yeah, great start to the second half by our Hornets here. Like you said, they're off to an 8-0 run. Let's see if they can continue with playing with the same energy and momentum coming out of the timeout so they can see if they can push this, increase this run and push their lead out to double digits.
So the Hornets this season have had some tough demoralizing losses here at Memorial Hall. by trying to close out the season strong with a win would just be their second in MEAC play.
Another great defensive possession there by the Hornets, forcing Charles Williams to take another bad shot, resulting in a miss for him.
So the Hornets bringing it on both ends of the floor to open up this second half. Morgan sizing up Collins, drives to the left, goes down low to Gasevich. Gasevich this time with the right hand, just a little bit too strong.
He's definitely got some good looks down there tonight, even though he is 1 for 6. But it seems like he's playing way more than the box score says. He's like we mentioned earlier, he's playing good defense, he's rebounding. He just hasn't been able to find his touch around the rim tonight. And there's Haywood doing what he does best, finding a knack for the ball, almost resulting in a steal for the Hornets.
DeAndre Haywood nearly forces another turnover. So 12 seconds to go on the shot clock now. And Haywood tips another pass. Or excuse me, that was Kalon Waller that tipped that pass away.
And like I mentioned earlier, the length of the front court for Delaware State right now is definitely affecting Howard. You had Devon Mallory there affecting the inbound pass, and Kalon Waller breaking up the tip pass.
Miller going to pull up from downtown, step back, fade away, no good. And Mallory comes up with the rebound. So another good defensive possession here in the second half by the Hornets.
Delaware State's looking real good right now. Everything's clicking on all cylinders. That's a great thing for them to see in their last home game.
And so now another opportunity to open the lead up to double digits. Morgan kicks it out to Waller. No good. And rebound snatched away. And now the outlet pass to Miller. Miller drives, gets the foul. And we'll see if the basket counts. I think they're going to say it didn't.
That's a good call. Foul was way before the basket. Should have been on the floor.
So that'll take us to the under 16 media timeout. And Howard has yet to get their first basket here in the second half. We'll see if they get it when we come back from the under 16 timeout. Collins with the inbounds pass over to JT Miller. He'll drive and kick it out to Mangham, who knocks down another one. And they're the first bucket of the second half. And no surprise, it's a three ball from Solomon Mangham.
Yeah, currently Howard's 1 for 6. Like Chris mentioned, that's their first basket. So definitely something to look forward to for Dell State. They're almost 5 minutes into the second half, and Howard just scoring their first basket. Let's see if Dell State can counter and respond with the bucket of their own.
And Mangham now with 15 points, nearly half of the Howard points, and all 15 have been via the three-point line. This one out of bounds off of Howard.
Just as I mentioned, three-point shooting for the Hornets was a key. I wasn't just talking about offensively. I was talking about defensively as well because those threes add up, as we can see. Howard's only down by six, and that's because of they made seven three-pointers that go along with the seven three-pointers that Delaware State has made.
Devon Mowry from mid-range off the inbounds pass, gets it to go.
Great move by Devon there. As I mentioned earlier, he can dribble, he can shoot. He has a nice mid-range jumper, very natural for a big man. He's 6'7", and he has length. He can do pretty much everything.
Yeah, he's really developed that mid-range game as his career has gone on. And now we talked about it in the last game, Devon Mowry, if there was a most improved player in the conference, as Damon Collins gets the lane, if there was a most improved player in the MEAC, certainly would have to think Devon Mallory would be in the running for it.
I'd agree. He's worked himself into the starting lineup for the Delaware State team, and he's played well.
And they go inside to Mallory again. He pump fakes, kicks it out, and just a little bit off the mark with that pass. Haywood was open for a three.
Yeah, he was ready to load that one up and shoot it. Another good finish there by Mallory. And a great pass by Haywood to find Mallory late in the shot clock.
DeAndre Haywood really has point guard abilities. I mean, you saw that pass there on the run with the left hand and dump off to Devon Mallory, who ends up with an easy lay-in.
Yeah, Haywood's got a nice stat line going on here. Currently has 10 points, 4 assists, and 4 rebounds.
And to make that 18 for Mangum, six three-pointers. He's got 18 points for Howard. And Hornets, that zone has really played right into Solomon Mangum, his hands.
Yeah, he's lighting it up from outside currently. I would think that Coach Walker is going to address that next time out and let them know that, hey, we got to start closing out or we got to start tightening up that zone because he has six threes so far throughout this game.
Even if they decide to stay in that zone, I would think they're going to stretch it out. Damon Collins there from just inside the free throw line gets the fall away jumper, and Howard continues to hang around.
Delaware State working the ball around, trying to find a good shot. 10 seconds left in the shot clock.
Morgan from way downtown, no good. Mallory's got another offensive rebound, but his layup attempt off the mark.
Looked like he tried to go around the defender there instead of going up over the top.
Collins' a shot, no good, but Marcel Boyd gets the offensive rebound, and now Miller wide open. No good, but Boyd another offensive rebound. And a foul this time going to be on, I believe, Kevon Waller.
And this is what I was mentioning before when I talked about rebounding for the Hornets. The Hornets' tallest player is Gasevich in 6'8". Howard's tallest player is 6'11", and Marcel Boyd. And you see that Gasevich is having some problems boxing him out and being able to grab defensive rebounds, which is resulting in extra possessions for Howard, which is keeping them in the game. They're only down by six here.
And you see here the replay. Miller was open. And yeah, that one on Kevon Waller. Three-pointer no good off the side of the backboard. The offensive rebound and the lay-in from Smith. But there's Charles Williams, another three, and it's off the side of the backboard. He is really off right now.
He's out of his game tonight. I don't know if it's the crowd that's getting him, if it's all the beautiful women that we got in the crowd tonight for Greek night, but he just didn't bring his game tonight, Chris.
And so you see now Demolo Onafade is checked in for Mirjan Gasevich. Mallory kicks it out to Waller, open for three. No good. And we've got a foul called on Marcel Boyd.
That was a great pass by Mallory. I didn't even think that he saw Waller out there on the wing, but he got it out there to him. He just couldn't knock down the three-pointer.
And so that will take us to the under 12 timeout. And Hornets only up by one, and now we'll go to the break. You can see here some replays. Here Mallory kicks it out to Waller, and Waller no good, and you see Boyd and Onafade going at it. But here they will honor their senior cheerleaders here at Delaware State University.
Show some love for all your lady cheerleaders, y'all. Put your hands together. We got four more Greeks left to go. Next up.
So 41-40 the score after the under 12 timeout. Solomon Mangham with 18 points for the Howard Bison. He's keeping them around. And now the Hornets trying to go to work here on offense. Get back in a rhythm. Onafade open and a travel. And you continue to see he just really struggles with the basketball in his hands.
It's just looking just very unnatural to him. Currently, and it's just a struggle to watch because you could tell he has potential. He's very athletic, very long. He just doesn't have the skill set right now to be a proficient offensive player, which will come to him. He's a very young player.
Mangham from downtown, no good. That one off the screen, he couldn't get it to go. And Joe Lewis at the scorer's table, I think he'll check in for Demola Onafade.
If I was a betting man, I would bet money that he was coming in for him as well, Chris.
Oh. And Waller trying to get it to Mallory over in the corner, and it's over his head, no good. And so Lewis will check in for Onafade. Lewis, a bit of a stretch four, stretch five kind of player. He can knock him down from the outside, but right now he's going to be asked to protect that painted area and play down low for the Hornets. Good job getting inside the zone. Jones kicks it out to Mangham, but he misses again.
Great defensive possession there for the Hornets. Many people don't know, but it's hard to box out in a 2-3 because you don't have a specific man. They just have an area, so you don't know what's coming behind you, what's coming from the side of you. So it's nice to see that the Hornets are still rebounding pretty well in that 2-3 zone. It's a good sight to see and a good key for them to win.
Mallory from that MEAC logo can't get it to go, just a little bit too strong. And after that 8-0 run to open up this second half, Hornets have slowed down a little bit on the offensive end. And Howard's back in it because of it. Mangham steps back, way short on this three. Hornets, you can see they're starting to get out to Mangham. He's not getting the easy looks he had earlier in the game.
Definitely, and I would assume that Coach Walker let them know, hey, you guys got to start closing out a little bit faster on that three because that's keeping them in the game.
So now under 10 minutes to go here in the ball game. Final regular season game for the Hornets. Inside to Mallory, shot no good, but Lewis collects it and gets the lay-in. And the Hornets back on the scoreboard there, a two-pointer from Lewis, and they're up three.
Once again, Dell State's height and length playing a key part there in that offensive rebound.
And Haywood the steal. DeAndre Haywood continuing to get it done on defense. And the shot blocked.
Oh, man, Chris, that we almost had a poster here. I was going to have to send that one to ESPN Top 10.
Collins wasn't going to let that happen. But Waller, good job staying with the play, getting the rebound. And laying it in, so the Hornets still get the 2 points, 45-40. Morgan, going for the steal.
As you can see, DeAndre Haywood not afraid to go up. DeAndre Haywood listed here at 6'2", Damon Collins 6'5", so he has a 3-inch advantage on him. and he was not afraid to go up, and unfortunately he just couldn't flush it down. That would have been a sight to see for us here.
I like the aggressiveness going forward on senior night, trying to fire up this crowd.
Hey, why not?
That would have got this crowd into it. All right, but a 45-40 lead. 8.5 minutes to go. Once again, final MEAC regular season game, final one at Memorial Hall, and Williams trying to get his first three to go, and he just cannot buy a basket right now. And the outlet to Haywood, he thought about pushing it, thought better of it, and the Hornets go back to work in the half court.
This is what they need right now, especially with this lead, slowing the game down, using the full shot clock, getting their half court game going.
Good pass inside to Waller. Waller finds Mallory. Can't get it off the glass. But Joe Lewis, another offensive board. And the Hornets will start over again.
Milk that clock.
Crowd applauding their effort.
All right, milk that clock down. Use as much as you can.
Haywood open in the corner. No good. And we get a block called on Joe Lewis. He doesn't like the call.
Seemed like they were going to call out of bounds call there. Look, from where I'm standing, he stepped out too, but I guess the blocking call came before he stepped out of bounds. Looks like we have a timeout here.
So that will take us to the under eight timeout. 45-40. And at the break, we will get another Greek performance. Again, tonight being Greek night.
Shout out to Wi-Fi. Shout out to the Wi-Fi. Oh, Wi-Fi, my bad. Okay. Okay. Some love for Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. I got one young fella. Come on, let's go. My young fella, let's go. Let's go. I'm going to give you one shot at the PlayStation. If you can hit a three-point shot, let's go. If you hit this three-point shot, you going to win the PlayStation. Young G, let's go. Hurry up. Oh. Come on, Young G. We love the kids. One shot. Hurry up. Hurry up. Oh, all right. No, off the court. No, 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 no. It's okay. Who dad told him come out here? Next time, I got you. All right,
back to the game.
So 45-40. Neither offense has been particularly sharp in this game, but we've got a close one, 45-40. And a five-second violation. Good defense out of the timeout from the Hornets.
Actually, it's surprising here. Dell State's up by five, but they're shooting 32% from the field. Howard's shooting 35% from the field. So, like Chris said, neither team shooting very well from the floor. But Delaware State still holds five-point lead over Howard, 45-40.
So Hornets now in the half court. Morgan thought about the corner three. Now trying to swing it over to Haywood, but it's stolen away by Miller. And now in transition, Williams pulls up the mid-range shot, no good. And he'll go to the foul line, but you can see the frustration on his face and in his emotions right now. He's just unhappy with the way he's played so far.
He's going through some growing pain. He's a freshman, true freshman. And he's just not having the best of night, which happens when you're on your own, when you're off, you're off. I don't want to go back to the rebounds here. Delaware State actually outboarding Howard by 12 here. Delaware State with 37 rebounds, Howard with 25. And that's a big reason why they're up currently now, despite them shooting worse than Howard has from the field.
So, Natea, real quick, want to get back to Williams. He's made the first free throw. It's only a four-point game. I mean, mentally, he's got to be thinking, I've just got to get going here for this last stretch, and we're going to win this basketball game. I mean, I think Howard's got to be confident that if Charles Williams gets going, they're going to win this game.
Yeah, because like we mentioned in the pregame, he averages 16 points a game, and now he has two. So the usual 14 that he has, which is not on the board. So we'll see what he could do in the last six or so minutes here to finish off the game.
Haywood drives to the basket, draws the foul, and so Haywood will go back to the line.
I'm loving his aggression here. He's going to the lane with no remorse, looking to either score a bucket or draw a foul. And that's a big foul for Marcel Boyd there. That's his fourth personal. When we still got 6 minutes and 52 seconds left into the game, and he plays a big part in their defense and their rebounding, being 6'11", being that tall, lanky and stocky man in the middle of their 2-3 zone.
So Haywood hits the first. Tell you one of the things I've liked so far, Haywood has now 11 points. Devin Morgan's got 11 points. Kevon Waller's got 11 points. You look at Howard, they've got one guy in double digits. Now he's almost got 20. But the Hornets, really a balanced effort, everybody getting involved.
Yeah, that's what you like to see. You like to see balance. You don't want to see one player doing all the scoring, because then your defense, the defense can single in on one person, and you don't want that. You want balance on your scoring. That's what Delaware State has with their three double-digit players. Let's see if Devon Mallory can hit some buckets and be Delaware State's fourth player in double digits.
So the Hornets brought the full-court press there, and they give up an easy basket. But how about that? The two big men on the other end, Lewis with the take and a little dump off with the right hand, and Mallory gets the easy lay-in.
That's easy points there, that 2-3. Once you get your man in the high post in the middle, drop it off to him, that man in the 2-3 has to come up. It opens up the whole back door, and that's what you just saw there.
Miller from downtown trying to bank it in. No good. And so now the Hornets back at it on offense. 6 minutes to go in the ball game. 49-44. Again, Hornets looking for just their second home win of the MEAC season. And here on senior night, it would be a big one.
Let's see if Delaware State goes back to that high post action in that 2-3.
Good defense from Damon Collins to knock it away from Joe Lewis. But he sticks with it and draws the foul. This one going to go against Tyler Stone. And so Lewis, for a big man, he's a good shooter. And him at the free throw line, you can have confidence in these.
I like what I'm seeing from Lewis coming off the bench. He's provided a good spark coming off the bench, rebounding, passing. He's made some good plays on the offensive and the defensive end.
And Lewis against the zone. He's a good shooter. He can handle the basketball. I loved him against the zone, getting to that free throw line. And he's tall, so he can see over defenders. He can do a lot against the zone. He can get in the middle of it and really create a lot of plays for your team.
Yeah, I believe he'll see some more minutes as we enter into tournament play, because I'm pretty sure the coach is seeing exactly what we're seeing tonight. He's making good plays on both sides of the ball.
And so Lewis goes 2-for-2 at the line, 51-44, with 5:44 remaining in the game. Hornets trying to pull away a little bit as the game goes on, trying to ensure their second home win of the MEAC season.
And like you mentioned before, the Hornets had some problems closing out games. I want to see how they do here with the 7-point lead that they have over Howard, that they can finally figure out how to close out a game, especially here being our last home game of the season.
Collins with a take to the basket, and Lewis knocks it away, but a foul called. And Tay, I don't know about you, but I don't like that call. Lewis was straight up and knocked it away.
I don't see it there. He barely left his feet. He just went straight up, hands up, and blocked it. I don't know where that foul call is coming from, but ball doesn't lie, as Kevin Garnett says.
I mean, it was hard contact, but Collins was attacking the basket very
right.
aggressively. Here you see it. Collins got it and drives hard. And Lewis, I mean, certainly he got all ball. So if there was a foul, it was on the collision there. But nonetheless, Collins is at the line and misses the first. And like you said, ball don't lie.
Ball don't lie. He's 0-for-1 so far. Let's see if he knocks down the second one.
And he goes 0-for-2.
And it holds true.
And so one surprise I've seen so far in this game, Kobe Gantz, the freshman, we've seen him play a lot this season, get big minutes. We have yet to see him today, But the Hornets up 51-44 despite his absence. Morgan with a drive, a dump off to Lewis. Great play there by Devin Morgan. And Lewis finishes around the basket. He's giving the Hornets some quality minutes here in the second half.
Yeah, I'm loving this play here tonight.
Lead up to 9. Hornets trying to seize the momentum here on senior night. Collins drives, but I think we're going to get a foul call beforehand on the floor. And it's going to be on Pavon Waller. And so that's Waller's fourth. And the Hornets now in the bonus, so this will be a 1-1 for Damon Collins.
And it's very strange because you look at these two leading scorers for Howard, which are Charles Williams and James Miller. Charles Williams has 2 points off of 2 free throws. He's currently 0 for 10. And James Miller is 2 for 5. He has 6 points. It's been Solomon Mangum that's kept the Bison in this game with his 6 threes.
So Collins gets that one to go. Said Kevon Weller's got his 4th foul, but he's going to stay on the floor. Also, Marcel Boyd for Howard, he's got 4 fouls. He's checked back into the game. So both the coaches recognizing we're late in the game. You got to put your best on the floor regardless of the number of fouls.
Yeah, this is the home stretch here, Chris. If you want to make a run, especially Howard being down by 7, they need their best 5 on the court right now to make this run and get back in this game.
Good job by the Hornets working through the press. And now in the half court, they'll go try and break this 2-3 zone that Howard's deploying. 10 on the shot clock. Haywood's got it, sizing up. Williams pulls up from downtown, gets it to go.
Knocks it down. That's a big shot by the senior. Big, big shot. Puts Dell State up by 10 over Howard, 56-46.
And the senior, you can see a little bit of a smile on his face. He can feel it. Playing well so far in this game, and 4 minutes to go. Mangum from downtown, no good. He's lost the shooting touch, and it's going to be a foul on Marcel Boyd, and he's going to foul out of this game.
And you love to see your point guard, or your guard, DeAndre Haywood, in there jumping up, going for that board, no matter who's down there. Like I mentioned before, Marcel Boyd is 6'11". DeAndre Haywood, 6'2". And he still went up, grabbed that board, and resulted in Marcel Boyd getting his 5th foul and fouling out of the game, which is huge for Howard. Here with us having 3 minutes and 51 seconds left in this game and then being down by 10 points.
Ladies and gentlemen, show some love for Zeta Phi Beta. We're my brothers. What is it about, ladies? Okay, Zeta Phi Beta. They messing with my check. Ho, yo, Zeta, Phi, Beta. Here we go. Hey. Show some love for the lovely ladies of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated. Make sure I say it right. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated. All right.
Tell you really quick, we get ready to go back to work here. 3:50 to go. What do the Hornets have to do to finish this one out? They're up 10.
They got to handle the ball. The Howard's going to try to press. They're going to try to create some turnovers. They need to take care of the ball, make sure they don't make any turnovers, make their free throws, because in a minute, as we see here, well, I was mistaken. I thought there was a foul there. But eventually Howard is going to start fouling, try to get Dell State to the line. shoot some free throws, knock their free throws down, they'll be able to finish this game out.
Well, the one thing you said that stands out, take care of the basketball. Now they're up 10. Howard's going to go into that full court press. We'll see how things transpire over the final 33-44.
All right, ladies. Show some love for Sigma Gamma Rho. Sorry, we just had to throw it in there and do a big old timeout on us.
So off the timeout, 3:44 to go again here in the ball game. Hornets up 56-46. Their defense has been exceptional here in the second half. And Haywood going to get this one stolen away. No, he's going to hang on to it.
Not quite yet, Chris. Not quite yet.
And a sloppy possession there. Howard turning up the intensity on this game. They know it's that time, and they get after the Hornets.
And Delaware State is supposed to be aware of this. They're supposed to know that they're starting to trap. Get out of that corner. But that's the easiest place to trap on the basketball court because the sideline is not your friend in this case. Get away from the sideline. Get the ball in the middle of the court where you can move and you can pass around.
Collins kicks it out to Williams, and Williams still cannot get it going. And we've got an offensive foul called on number 22, Devin Morgan. It's only Morgan's second, but it will send Howard to the free throw line, and JT Miller is the man at the line. But Charles Williams, you saw there, just, you know, it was time, and you felt like if he got that three to go, it would have been big for Howard, but it just has not been his day.
Delaware State has to be careful here. With Howard has a chance to cut the lead down to 8. There's still a little bit over 3 minutes left here, and there's a chance for Howard to get back in this game. Delaware State has to wake up and have to finish this game out.
And at the scorer's table, Kobe Gantz talked about him a minute ago. They just want another ball handler on the floor, and so now the Hornets with three guys who can handle the basketball against this press. Good switch, good substitution there by Coach Walker.
Yeah, very smart substitution there, like you said. Putting pretty much five ball handlers on the floor.
And there it is. You see Kobe Gantz. Morgan pulls up from mid-range, no good. And fortunate they're able to get the offensive rebound. Probably not a smart shot from Morgan.
No, I don't like that shot at all. You don't need to score here. You need to take the all 30 seconds off of the shot clock that you need. And that's not a shot that Delaware State wants there, but like you said, lucky enough they got the rebound, and now they're able to milk the clock out.
And now they're beginning to play smart basketball, really working every second of the clock, and now a charge going to be called against Kobe Gantz. So you kill some clock, that's a good job, but you're not at the point where you can stop scoring. They've got to continue to execute on offense. It'll just have to be later in the shot clock.
Right, because a three here from Howard cuts the game down to a 5-point game, which is a two-possession game. There's still 2 minutes and 45 seconds left in this game, Chris.
Gantz tried to dump it off to Mallory. But 56-48, Lewis checks back in, a little defense for offense substitution, and this one knocked away, and Lewis comes up with it, so the Hornets get a steal.
Great defense there by the Hornets. Once again, that length comes into play. Oh, wow. I don't know about that call there.
And Haywood doesn't like it. The Hornet crowd doesn't like it. But Howard will get another possession. Hornet's going to have to continue to hang their hat on the defensive end.
Howard's hanging in there. I have to give tip my hat to them. They're resilient right now. I mean, the refs are helping them out a little bit here, but they got to get some points up on the board if they want to even think about making a comeback here. They're still down 8.
Collins thought about pulling up from 3. Here's Mangham from downtown. Can't get it to go. And Lewis with the rebound. That's Joe Lewis has really given this Hornets team some quality quality minutes here in the second half.
That's a big miss there from Mayhem. You think that all his field goals coming from three, he was going to knock that one down. He hasn't. And as I say that, Delaware State has turned the ball over once again for the fourth time in about a minute and a half here, giving Howard another chance to score.
Yeah, another turnover. Haywood lost it out of bounds, trying to get it to Joe Lewis. And Mangham, another three, can't get it to go, and so he has officially cooled off. And now here comes Morgan the other way, crosses over Collins, switches to the left hand, no good. And now here comes Howard. They've got a 2-on-1 break the other way. And a great charge taken there by Kevon Waller.
Wonderful. That's just a smart play there. He didn't try to swipe at the ball or try to block that. He knew that Howard was going to be aggressive on the offensive end, trying to get a bucket, and he stood there. He took the charge. It's now Delaware State basketball. And here's the foul. So like I mentioned earlier, now it's time for Delaware State to lock in, finish this game off, knock down their free throws so we can walk out of here in Memorial Hall with the win.
And you see there the replay of Kevon Waller. A great job there to get in front, get set, and take the charge. And Howard commits the intentional foul, so they'll send Devin Morgan to the free throw line. 1:47 to go. Hornets on the verge of a win to close out the regular season and head into the MEAC tournament. Up 8, and they've only allowed 20 points here in this second half. They've been fortunate. Howard hasn't been great with some of their open shots, but they've had blocks, they've had steals. Saw Kevon Waller take the charge. The Hornets have been excellent on the defensive end in this game tonight.
They definitely have. Looking here in the 30 games that Del State has played, they have allowed their opponent to score 76 points on average. Tonight, only allowing Howard to score 48, which is great. It's a great margin. Hopefully they can take this defensive effort into the MEAC tournament and continue playing this well.
So JT Miller gets to the rim, gets the easy lay-in, and Coach Nickelberry calls the timeout. So 57-50, a minute and a half to go. Howard not going away just yet.
Yeah, this game definitely is not over. A couple of missed free throws and some threes. Howard can still get into this game. Delaware State needs to go to the line and take care of business, finish this win out.
All right. Show some love for the Iotas. All right, Iotas. I know. Y'all tired anyway.
So 57-50, minute and 38 to go. And the Hornets with the basketball, but Howard staying in this full court press. Vance catches the inbounds pass, and he's going to break it himself over to Mallory with the right hand lay-in and one.
And one.
Kevon Mallory with a big time answer there for the Hornets, and he's going to go to the line with a chance to make the lead 10.
And I believe that's a dagger, Chris. That's a great way of breaking the press by Gantz. Great way to look up, find Mallory, and a great job by the big man finishing with the right hand scoop and getting the and one. Let's see if he can knock down the free throw and push this lead to 10.
And give credit to Kobe Gantz there, though, definitely catching the inbounds pass and finding Mallory open.
You can definitely see those fresh legs in effect there. He dribbled past three defenders, breaking that press easily and finding Mallory for the two.
And the freshman, him and Devin Morgan, are going to make one heck of a tandem. And now Collins called for the travel. He lost the footing, and the pivot foot moved. And so now the 9-point lead, and the Hornets will get the basketball with a minute and 22 to go. Hornets closing in on that win. They're finishing this one strong. They've struggled to finish games here at Memorial Hall. Every game here has been close except for the NC Central one. But they've struggled to finish him out. They're finishing this one strong.
Yeah, I believe the atmosphere of senior night definitely got to the Hornets, made them open up their eyes and say, hey, we got to win this for our guys. And they definitely came out here and took care of business.
Waller, the leg laying, no good, but he gets the tap. And the lead 11 with a minute to go. Hornets trying to get this win on senior night. Stone from the free throw line gets it to go. And Coach Nickelberry going to use the final timeout for the Bison. And I get the feeling the Hornets want to get this one put away so that they can check out Howard and Gasevich and get them a round of applause. But they've got to finish this one off. They struggled to finish. This would be an epic meltdown, but we've seen them have the meltdowns in the past this season. With the crowd into it and on their backs right now. So the Hornets to inbound, and we've got a whistle, and I think it's going to be a foul on JT Miller. It will, and so DeAndre Haywood's going to go to the free throw line, and these free throws could put this game on ice.
Yeah, Chris, Delaware State definitely scared us a little bit with the turnovers around the two-minute mark, but they definitely came here and finished business in the last 2 minutes, taking care of the ball and knocking down the free throws, and they finished out. A good victory here for us on senior night.
So the senior with the free throws to put it on ice, and he knocks down the first 10-point lead. Haywood now with 16 in the game, leading the Hornets. Second leading scorer in the game, Solomon Mangham, the only guy with more points than him, and Haywood hits them both. So 17 points for the senior here in his final game at Memorial Hall. Miller the other way, drives to the basket, gets the lay-in. And so now the Hornets got to knock down the free throws. High pass, Haywood comes up with it. And he'll bring it out.
And this one's
and Charles Williams going to foul. I think Coach Nickelberry wanted it a little bit sooner than that, but Haywood will go back to the line.
Good way to turn the pad his stats in this last game, knocking down these free throws. Hopefully he can get him a 20-point game as his last home game as a Hornet here with us.
So Haywood gets the first.
After he makes his foul shot, let's tell him what they need to start up.
And Haywood misses the second, but still a 10-point lead. And a shot block, Joe Lewis finishing off the quality minutes, and here's Haywood, the senior,
hey,
to throw it down.
What a way to go.
And
out.
Let's go home, Hornets. That one will do it. The Hornets going to get the win here on senior night. Miller gets the lay-in as a formality, but a 10-point lead, and DeAndre Haywood, how fitting to get that dunk to close out the career here at Memorial Hall. And Howard won't foul.
And as you hear the crowd getting loud, they're happy, we're all happy. Hornets win 66-56 over Howard.
So Delaware State able to get that second home win of the MEAC season. They went 5-3 on the road this season in the MEAC. Obviously, tournament play, as you see, Haywood's dunk to close out his career here at Memorial Hall. But they were 5-3 on the road. There's no home games in the MEAC tournament, so the Hornets have a chance in the MEAC tournament to make some noise. Tay, what do you expect from them in this tournament?
Well, I expect them to build on the performance that they had tonight. They played good defense, they rebounded well, and they shot the ball well. They can take this into the tournament. Who knows what they can do? They can go all the way because, as you said, there's no home games in the MEAC tournament, and everybody's 0-0 once the tournament starts. Your regular season record does not matter once tournament play starts. So I look for them to build on this performance, take this confident win, and take the momentum that came with this win and use it in their next game in the MEAC.
So there it is, the Hornets win in their final home game of the season on senior night. Congratulations to DeAndre Haywood and Merjon Gasevich on their great Hornet careers. You can catch all of the MEAC games on Watch ESPN. But that will do it for us here at WDSU-TV this basketball season. For myself, I'm Chris Moore, Tavon Calloway, all of us here at WDSU-TV, we thank you for tuning in and supporting us and the Hornet basketball team all season long. Once again, the Hornets close out the MEAC season with their second home win of the season, 66-56. Good night, everybody.